Harold McCanick.
Okay, Mr. Mechanic. I was trying to find a way that we can get to 7 o'clock without hearing Mr. Mechanic. Just kidding.
Wow.
That was not nice.
Nice to see you too, Mr. President. There's a reported pig lady in the northeastern reaches of Maryland. The idea of a pig woman roaming Cecil County saw the legend as an opportunity to begin production on a full-length feature film. I want to make a film that builds an old legend into a terrifying ordeal. The film is created using local resources, including the budget. We feel like it's an opportunity for local actors to get a part in a film that showcases their talent and tells a story. We'd also like to hear stories from locals that gives us a flavor of how the legend has been told over the years. Now I have a contemporary version. May I submit, I have a character in mind for the pig lady.
Just speak to the council and don't pick out names, please.
I haven't.
What does he have to do with...
He has 5 minutes to state his opinions.
Yeah, well, this is consistent with what...
Mr. Mechanic...
You didn't interrupt the last speaker.
Mr. Mechanic, would you please finish?
This is a good example of how you're not enforcing the rules.
And you're not?
Mr. Mechanic, don't...
Hypocrisy.
Mr. Mechanic, address the council. Keep it short, please, Harold.
I don't get 5 minutes?
Go ahead.
Harold Mechanic, Elk Neck Peninsula, also known as the Peninsula of Paradise. One of the council members suggested that she like to have tools to get the job done. This follows up what Mr. Lobos was just saying. I have a tool for a council person. She's out of order.
Please proceed. Please just keep it respectful.
Next time you have trouble holding your tongue at a meeting, this is duct tape. You need to put some of this in your toolbox. She's out of order. You're not authorized to use that, and I'm not done.
What's the penalty?
How about the penalty? How about the penalty using this piece of duct tape now?
I'm supposed to respect this process, but you know he's not supposed to.
You'll have your time in a minute. All right, is that it, Harold?
That is. Thank you.
Harold Mechanic, Elk Neck. Good evening, Council, and Mr. President. I'd like to revisit last Council meeting that included public comment and specifically Citizens Corner. There was a couple who expressed dismay about noise. Motorcycle noise, to be exact. An adjacent property owner allows operation of motorcycles on his property, causing their peace and quiet to be disturbed. I offer my expertise as a former professional rider to try and find a solution. You see, before I turned pro, I rode around in empty lots and caused this kind of disturbance. It wasn't my intention to disturb anyone, but rather to chase a dream of becoming a champion. As my career evolved, my equipment changed from loud closed course race bikes to cross country and off-road machines that are sound tested before and after each competition. I learned to build quiet bikes that were exceptionally fast. And guess what? I still have my bikes, perfectly preserved and still functional. Now, do you think these people's council representative would welcome this opportunity at a solution? Of course not. You see, their district representative is Diana Brumell. Her solution was to task the county executive with the problem, then attempt to discredit me, a qualified professional and former champion.